over anybody.
He was the preacher behind those end of the world predictions.
97% of the people God will destroy.
I don't believe in such
judgment days that kept coming and going.
The world did not end. We are still.
But now the world has ended for Harold Camping long after he predicted it would. Predictions so wrong that he once said reporters would be thinking,
I'm ready to shoot myself or go on a booze trip.
He was wrong in 1994 and again when he announced the end would come May 21st, 2011. One follower spent $140,000 on ads warning of Judgment Day.
That's your life savings.
A good chunk of it.
A documentary filmmaker followed Robert Fitzpatrick to Times Square to ring in the end of the world.
It's 6 o'clock!
And of course, nothing happened.
I didn't water my plants. I didn't do the dishes before I left. I didn't expect to be going back home.
And though you felt sorry for some who believed, it was hard not to mock.
But this is my birthday. To put this on me is just weird.
Happy Doomsday, dear Jeanne.
The rapture, true believers ascending to heaven, was also mocked when it didn't happen, with photos showing clothing left behind.
But if it had happened, it might have looked like this.
When May 21st came and went, Camping revised the date to 5 months later.
At that time, the whole world will be destroyed.
Eye-rolling reporters got a tongue-lashing from a supporter.
And you can't just turn your cameras on him when you have taken and run with this, and you love this story because it's good for you.
Who can resist end-of-the-world stories with end-of-the-world parties?
Only the good die.
Camping wasn't young. He was 92 when his radio network said he passed on to glory this past Sunday after suffering from a fall last month. He did eventually apologize for his prediction, saying, "We tremble before God as we humbly ask him for forgiveness for making that sinful statement." His own reports of his death were always premature.
Yeah, but I'm not going to be here after October 23rd.
Jeanne Moos, CNN, New York.